stumbled onto a little white bass pattern today. I'm at Smithville Lake in Missouri, western Missouri, trying to catch walleye. It's mid-April, and I'm not, but there's a bunch of white bass. Anyway, let me take a screenshot and I'll show you what I'm doing. Okay, I'll show you. Anyway, I keep seeing bumps on the bottom that I was assuming were walleye, but they're obviously white bass. But they're kind of scattered everywhere. So I put my marker buoy on the apex or the top of this big ass point, flat, whatever you want to call it, that juts out with deep water all the way around it. And then I'm just perfectly upwind of it, casting to my marker buoy. That way I can feel my spoon or jig as I'm bringing it back to the boat. And I'm just getting whacked on almost every cast with white bass. But the trick is, don't throw it to the side. It's so windy right now, if I throw it over here, over there, I can't feel it. But if I throw it way behind the boat, straight behind the boat, I can feel it and set the hook when I'm getting hit. I'm just clinging out there as far as I can, perfectly downwind, which is perfectly at my buoy, which is perfectly at the apex of this point. I'm sitting in 30 foot of water, and I dropped my buoy in 14, right at the top as I was coming over. What I'm using for these little guys, it's a 1/2 ounce Bink spoon and Fire Tiger, and I got a 20 pound fluorocarbon leader, an 8 pound nano fill, and I think the thin super line helps me feel. If I had mono, I would never have felt that line. And the nice thing about using a 1/2 ounce spoon and flinging a mile out there, I mean, I'm covering a huge swath of this area from the same boat position. And on colors, I'm pretty simple. Mainly I use Fire Tiger in stain water, and white in clear water is probably my favorite. I have different colors I try. That's usually what I start with. I caught that one like on the second crank, and the one before was probably 2/3 of the way back to the boat. So, just stayed there.